Here's Kobe at the top, works on Turkoglu to the left. Turkoglu blocks the shot from behind. This as the horn sounds, a defensive gem by Turkoglu.
Turk! Hito! Come on, it's winning time!
6/10 of a second remaining.
Turkoglu again will trigger. Odom jumping up high to obscure his view. A lob to the basket for Lee, who caught it, laid it up, no good! And we'll go to overtime. You guys said Lee was open. He popped free. Turkoglu made a great pass, and the rookie out of Western Kentucky almost had the moment of a basketball lifetime. It rims out, and we go to overtime.
We worked 100 games to get
to
this point.
Let's get it.
Every practice, every drill we've been through to get this opportunity to win a championship.
And in overtime, the Lakers took control behind the tandem of Kobe and Powell.
Bryant looks inside, finds Gasol. Gasol counted. And a foul.
Game two to L.A. in OT. Streamers fall from the roof of the Staples Center. The Los Angeles Lakers are two wins from a 15th NBA title.
We've been doing a really good job of talking and understanding what it's going to take at certain times.
We did that perfectly.
LeBron
Jordan! Now we're in line the whole time. In line the whole time. So now you don't know what to do. You're not behind me. You're not in front of me. You're right there parallel with me. So now when he came, that was a quick shovel pass to you.
We know that it all starts with us, so we have to set the tone verbally and also playing.
Their whole defense is cocked towards me and Powell. So he and I are in constant dialogue of what we see, adjustments that we can make on the fly. And we've been kind of trying to time that up the right way the whole game. And it just didn't work out for us, and at the right time it did.
If we can time that up and be right in line with each other on those.
Well, that wasn't our finest moment, but we found a way to win it, guys. That was really a good win. Pull that sucker out.
If you don't walk out with a win, you didn't do the right stuff. But we fought hard. We had chances to win. We didn't get it done. We got to go home and play a great game in game three and get the win.
I'm coming to you live, believe you me. Orlando is where you want to be. This is the championship, 2009. One team will win this bump and grind. I'm Dr. Geek. This is the way I speak. I'll see you later. I got to find my seat.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Game 3 of the 2009 NBA Finals. What an amazing atmosphere, and you can't blame them. What a great season it's been, but they are desperate for a victory right now.
It's our turn right now. You know, they did their part, they killed home court. Now it's our turn.
Beat L.A. It's crazy, because we're going to make 50, and they're going to win 3-0 today here in Amway Arena. Kobe owns this building right here.
That's not right, man. Let's see what happened.
As the series shifted to Orlando, the Lakers had a 3-0 lead in their sights, and Kobe Bryant was ready to make it a reality.
What we gonna do, Purple? What we gonna do? Let's go. Keep that energy up, PJ. Let's go get them. Play hard. What time is it? Get to home.
Kobe Bryant is definitely energized to get off to a good start.
Bryant gets it back with 9 on the clock. Petrus in pursuit. Bryant double team.
Kobe gets 20 feet, shoots, and hits a ridiculous shot.
It's almost like a grown man playing with kids. I'm going to do whatever I want. I'm going to make every play.
Bryant nails the 3 and a chance for a 4-point play.
Get your energy up. Get some turnovers. Get out of transition. Let's go.
Listen. He's on fire. They're on fire. They're playing great. Stay with our game. Keep our energy up. Stay disciplined. All right, let's go.
As sizzling as Kobe had been, the Magic were about to get even hotter, shooting their way back into the series.
Gasol against Lee here on a mismatch. Lee fires from 18. It's good.
Bryant, tough shot won't go. Howard, the rebound. After the slow start shooting, the Magic really shooting the ball well. Petrus is in. Off to Turkoglu. The floater. That's good. Magic a hot now.
Turkoglu goes right side for an Austin 3. Good.
Now what a performance from the Magic. 75% shooting again, an NBA Finals record for a half. The only reason the lead wasn't much bigger is 21 from Kobe Bryant, who was absolutely sensational.
Yeah, we will keep our heads and play together. We'll win this game. We're fine. We will win the game.
In the third quarter, the Magic maintained their lead as they looked for the first Finals win in franchise history. The Lakers started to close the gap, and it was the Magic's turn to respond.
Come on! That's not enough fight right there! Are you willing to throw your body in there and get hit or not? If you're not, you're not winning! And if you will, you will win!
The coach had made his statement, and now the Magic made theirs, with defensive pressure that stopped the Lakers cold.
Got to give credit to the Magic defense. All of a sudden, the Lakers offense, they look uncomfortable.
Shot clock at 6. Alston double, back to Lewis. That's a two-pointer. Puts it in. Rashard Lewis nails it. Clutch shot from Rashard Lewis.
Big play right there.
Now there was little doubt as to where the Lakers would turn.
Kobe going to bring it front court. 35 seconds left. They trail by 2. Kobe Bryant left, right, lost it.
Stolen by Petras, but Gasol gets it back. Lost it again, and Petras is fouled.
What a play. What a great play by Petras.
And for the first time ever, the Orlando Magic have won an NBA Finals game, and our series is on.
Game 4, Orlando is going to be rocking. We're going to be pumping. Dunking, jumping, blocking, everything. We're trying to take this home, baby. Hey, if you don't believe, you better start believing. This will be coming.
It is a tough team. It's not a cupcake team. It's a tough loss for us. And, you know, we feel like we can play much, much better. So tomorrow, just make your adjustments and get ready to go.
Phil Jackson had won 9 NBA championships as a head coach and now was in search of a 10th that would set the all-time record. And with his team locked in a tough finals battle against the Magic, Phil had his Lakers hard at work.
The eye of the ball carrier is going to be on what Howard does, because then they're going to see who collapses and then they'll know where the spacing is almost blind.
His philosophy and just the way he approaches the game is so much more than just X and O's and playing hard and that type of thing.
Come on, run the court right. Run the court right. You guys are running the court all funky.
He treats every person different depending on how he feels is the best way to motivate them.
I think we have to load up. No, wait. Hold on, listen to me, all right? He's bringing the ball down.
He kind of just teaches you an entire mindset of, you know, staying at a constant level and not getting too high and not getting too low.
That's a Lamar Odom type pass there.
Good pass, boy.
I love Phil. I mean, I love him as a coach, but I also love him as a guy, as a person. He's very unique.
But, yo, this is the one where you go and then right to the basket.
I think it's intellectually stimulating, the way he talks to you, the way he tries to approach you, the way he jokes around.
Phil Jackson and Kobe Bryant had won 3 championships together earlier in the decade. Back then, their relationship had often been stormy. Now, years later, they had forged a growing bond.
The two of them going through what they did early on in their career, bumping heads a lot of times, now they both appreciate each other even more.
We have to...
It would be a classic example of one is a teacher, one is a student. And a student goes to class to gain knowledge and to learn from the teacher. However, the teacher learns just as much from the student.
Some people may not understand his methods, but if you've played for him, you know, you understand him completely and you know what he's about. I mean, he's just absolutely brilliant.
Look ahead.
Bringing a group together to accomplish one common goal.
Look ahead. Look ahead.
Oh. More than ever, Jackson had his Lakers believing in themselves and in each other.
Phil is a rare individual, you know, in terms of
being a coach that doesn't try to tell you exactly how to do everything. He really gives you the space to step into what you want, your individual.